हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट वुमेन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। दिस इज लेक्चर वन ऑन एंटीना बेसिक एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक थ्योरी सीरीज। एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एंटीना डेफिनेशन, एंटीना टाइप्स एंड रेडिएशन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द एंटीनाज। द फॉलोइंग कंटेंट्स विल बी एड्रेस ड्यूरिंग दिस लेक्चर वन ऑफ दिस सीरीज। The basic communication system, then antenna as a transition device, then types of antenna, and finally the radiation mechanism. The contents of this lecture one of this series is prepared with the help of following books. As we know that in a basic communication system, there are having five components. Initially the source, then transmitter, channel, receiver and destination. So we can say this is the process of basic communication systems. If suppose we are taking the example of cellular communication system, in this cellular communication system we can say that it is a two wireless communication transmission between the cellular phone and handset and the base station tower and vice versa. So how we can understand it, here you can see this is a transmitter and this is the channel or communication medium. Here you can consider at the transmitting side is the cellular phone handset or the mobile phone, and at the receiver side you can consider as a base station tower, or the reverse process or vice versa you can consider. In that case, between the transmission or transmission of the information from cellular phone to the base station, and in the reverse direction, base station to the cellular phone. So we can communicate through this basic communication systems. And how this mechanism is performed with the in a cellular communication system. So we can consider a cell phone. Here you can see we have considered at the transmitting side, we have considered the cell phone, and that cell phone convert audio signal into the electrical form and using a microphone, as you can see in your phone. So by using microphone we have convert the audio signal into the electrical form, and then for in a transmitter section we have convert this audio signal, or we can say electrical form of the signal, into the high frequency carrier signal by the process of modulation. Then some other process we are also undergoing in the transmitter section. Then we have transmitted the modulated signal by using the antennas, and then further the modulated carrier signal radiated into the free space as a electromagnetic wave, which is picked up by the base station tower that we have considered at the receiving side. Similarly, the signal transmitted by the tower are received by the handset, and thus creating a two-way communication, or we can say two-way wireless transmission. So we can say that some basic mechanism through which we can transmit our audio signal to the destination by considering the following sections or block structures, that are transmitter and receiver. And here you can see the channel is a wired channel or maybe the wireless, but we are considering here it's a cellular communication system. In that case it is a wireless medium, and in that case the transmitter section transmits the electromagnetic energy and receiver antenna is receiving the electromagnetic energy. And we can say that antenna as a transition device, how we can see, so we are considering this is the transmitting section and this is the receiving section. So here you can see after transmitter we are considering the antenna, and this is the channel, and this is the receiving antenna section. So here you can see by using a generator or the transmitter we have created in a two wire transmission line. Here you can see this is a two wire transmission line, and in this transmission line the guided TEM, transverse electromagnetic waves, will be generated as per the current that flow in this transmission line. As you can see, this is the transmission line, the current flow in a transmission line, and this is the tripper transition. And in a tripper transition, according to the sinusoidal electromagnetic waves, the transition region we have considered as a antenna, and the free space waves radiating in a three-dimensional space. But in a transmission line, the electromagnetic with TEM waves in a one-dimensional wave. And here you can see some loops are created. These loops are created due to the presence of, or due to the presence of current in a transmission line and on a taper transition. And this current using create the magnetic field as well as the electric field. Electric field is created due to the presence of the flux of the charges. Similarly, in a receiving antenna, these electric field lines are, we can say it's a plane waves. These plane waves are impinged on the receiving antenna structure, and this taper transition we have considered as a transition region or the antenna. And here you can see this is the direction of the current flow, and here again the guided TEM waves will be generated when the electromagnetic waves impinge on the receiving antenna with some specific processing units, then we can receive at the receiver. So this is the basic mechanism or of the antenna, and we can say this process of the transmitting antenna to the receiving antenna of the electric and magnetic field creation, the antenna act as a transition device. We can define the definition of the antenna with some specific standards, and in IEEE standard we can define that the antenna or aerial we can also say as a means of radiating or receiving radio waves, or an antenna is a transition device or transducer between a guided wave and a free space wave, and vice versa. The important is here the spacing between the two wire line is assumed to be a small fraction of the wavelength. And here you can see in a transmitting antenna, the region of transition from guided wave, I mean guided one-dimensional guided EM waves on a transmission to a free space wave, electromagnetic waves. And conversely, in the receiving antenna, here you can see receiving antenna is, it is a region of transition from a space wave to the guided wave over transmission line. The current on the transmission line flow out on the antenna and end there, but the field associated with them keep on going. And here you can see the field is created due to the current is created by magnetic field as well as the flux due to, by considering the Coulomb's law, it is created the electric field. So we can define the another definition of the antenna, that we can say the antenna must also serve as a directional device in addition to a probing device, because the it radiates energy in some direction and suppress it in other directions. And this definition we can understand when we are going to discuss about different kinds of antenna, or we can say we can also categorize the antenna in terms of their characteristics or antenna parameters. And then further we are going to discuss about types of antenna. Broadly we can categorize the antenna in two forms or two types. First is the wire antenna and another is the aperture antenna. In a वायर एंटीना वी कैन अगेन क्लासिफाइड इन थ्री कैटेगरीज और सम कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दीज कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट इज द वायर एंटीना, देन सेकेंड इज द लूप एंटीना एंड थर्ड इज द एरे और लीनियर एरेज. इन ए वायर एंटीना कैटेगरी देर आर सम स्पेसिफिक टाइप ऑफ एंटीनाज लाइक स्मॉल डाइपोल, क्वार्टर वेवलेंथ मोनोपोल, हाफ वेवलेंथ डाइपोल एंटीना, फोल्डेड डाइपोल एंटीना, लॉन्ग वायर वी एंटीना, रोम्बिक, हेलिकल एंड स्पाइरल्स. दिस टाइप ऑफ एंटीना कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ वायर एंटीना और वी कैन से डाइपोल और वी कैन से इट्स ए लीनियर और कर्व्ड एंटीनाज. Here you can see it's a loop antenna, and the loop antenna is we can categorize small circular, ferrite loop, polygon loops, or any other of shape of the loop antennas. And in a linear array form, we can categorize broadside, endfire, scanning array, phased array, binomial array, Yagi-Uda array, log period array, or combination of them. So we can categorize the wire antenna in these categories. And further, we have categorized the aperture antenna by this block or flow structure or block diagram. Here you can see we can categorize the aperture antenna in a horn antenna category, reflector antenna category, slot antenna category, lens antenna category, microstrip antenna categories, and aperture antenna arrays. So we have categorized, and these subcategories are sectoral, pyramidal, horn, conical, and corrugated, or other combination may be possible. In reflector antenna, plane reflector, corner reflector, parabolic and spherical reflector antennas or some combination of them. In microstrip antenna, rectangular, circular, elliptical and some kind of geometries that can be comes under the category of microstrip antenna. Slot antenna, we can define slot dipole, slot waveguide, slot spiral antenna, some kind of antenna that comes under the category of slot antenna. In aperture antenna, we can define different kinds of aperture antenna, especially the Yagi-Uda aperture antennas, microstrip patch array, slotted waveguide array that comes under the category of aperture antenna. And we can also categorize in terms of lens antenna, and in lens antenna come having the dielectric lens, metaplex lens, convex, concave and convex antennas, and concave and concave antennas, convex and convex antennas, some kind of antennas that comes under the category of lens antenna. This type of antenna we have discussed in the subsequent lecture of this series one by one, or some other variant of these kind of antenna may also be possible in the case of linear wire antenna, or we can say wire antennas, or in the case of aperture antenna. Further, we are going to understand the radiation mechanism of the antenna, and it is very important how does the antenna should be radiate. So for to understand the radiation mechanism of the antenna, we have considered a time varying voltage or current, and this time varying voltage or current is applied to a conductor. Here you can see this conductor we have considered, or we can see it's a wire. Free electrons are accelerated. The acceleration or deacceleration of these electrons cause a radiation to occur. How we can understand this is the basic principle of radiation mechanism. So let us assume that this is a linear cylindrical wire, and in this cylindrical wire the charge is uniformly distributed on the entire cross sectional area, and we have considered QV is the charge density on this, and the cross sectional area of a wire we have considered, this is the cross sectional area that we have considered is A, and the volume of this wire antenna or the conductor is we have considered as a V. So the total charge Q within volume V is moving in the Z direction. This is the we are putting it is along the Z direction, then, or we can say it's a straight piece of wire with a uniform velocity. This is the uniform velocity that we have represented v of z meter per second. So this is the configuration that we have considered to understand the radiation mechanism of the antenna. If the wire is a very thin, ideally zero radius, this is assumption we have considered, then the current in a wire can be expressed I of z is equal to q of l into v of z, where q of l is the charge per unit length and vz is the velocity. If the current is time varying, as we have defined initially, that the derivative of the current dIz upon dt is equal to QL dVz upon dt and equal to Q of L A of Z. So here the ratio of the differentiation of the velocity, I mean dVz upon dt, which is equal to A of Z, and it is called as a acceleration. So we can say that if the wire of length L, that can then this equation 2 can be represented as L dIz upon dt equal to L into QL dVz upon dt is equal to L QL AZ. So this is the basic radiation equation and through which we can define the radiation mechanism of the antenna. Here dIz upon dt is the time changing current and we have measure ampere per second. L is the length of the linear conductor or wire or current element. Q of L is the charge per unit length, and or L is the length that we have considered, or L into Q we can also represent by the charge capital of Q and that charge in coulombs. And dVz upon dt is the time change of velocity, which equals to the acceleration of the charges that we have measured in meter per second square. So from the equation 3, we can be observed that to create a radiation, there must be a time varying current or acceleration or deacceleration of the charges, as you can see in the basic radiation equation that we have expressed in equation 3. To create the charge acceleration and deacceleration, the wire must be curved, bent, continuous and terminated. Here you can see this is the various forms of wire configuration, and through these wire configuration antennas we can create the radiation by some specific correct properties that are the curved, bent. Here you can see bent, this is truncated, and this is the discontinuous in the form of diameters, and we can connect it as a load. In that case we can create the radiation on this wire configuration. In a summary form, we can define, if a charge is not moving, current is not created and there is no radiation. This is the first case. If the charge is moving with the velocity, as we have discussed in the case of a conductor or in a wire, that there is no radiation if the wire is straight and infinite in extent. There is a radiation if the wire is curved, bent, discontinuous, terminated or truncated, as we have seen in figure 2. If the charge is oscillating in a time domain, it radiates even if the wire is straight, as can be seen in figure 3. And we have considered the case of lambda 2 wire antenna, half wavelength wire antenna. So here you can see this is the case of half wavelength wire antenna at different time instant. So we are considering the different time instant for a some specific period that is belongs to the 0 to T by 2. In that case, we have considered this is a lambda by 2 dipole, and this dipole is central fed, and this is the direction of the current we have assumed, and so this is the current flow and this is the current created on the dipole antenna at t is equal to 0, and having the maximum current at where we are feeding the center fed dipole. Here you can see after some instant t is equal to t by 8, the maximum current at the feed is reduced about 1 by root 2 times, or we can say it's having the value of input current, or we can say I, which is equal to 0.707. then t is equal to t by 4, it is reduces and having the minimum current at the center fed dipole. Further, at t is equal to 3 t by 8, as you can see, again it is the process of t by 8. So we can say it is the first harmonic, odd harmonic, and this is the third harmonic, and this is the case of 5. In that case, at t is equal to t by 2, as you can see, the current is reversed. Here you can see this is in upward direction and this is in the downward direction, and the current maximum I naught is occurred at the center where we are feeding this dipole antenna, and this current we have considered is a constant current, and this can be occur only when this current mechanism, as we are given in equation 3a, and it is multiplying the current standing waveform by the term cos omega t. In that case, we are getting this radiation mechanism for a different times on a lambda 2 type wire antenna, or we can say dipole antenna. And the detailed analysis about the lambda by 2 wire or dipole antenna we have discussed in the separate lecture of this another series. So we can say the radiation occurs in three cases. The important thing that we have observed here is the duration of the pulse is shorter than the antenna produce broader bandwidth and stronger radiation, and this can be understood through the case of ultra wideband antenna, because this antenna having a wide bandwidth and which is about 7.5 gigahertz, or we can also define in the case of broadband antenna. In that case, if the antenna having the bandwidth more than 25%, in that case that type of antenna comes into the category of ultra wideband antenna. Conversely, a sinusoidal variation produces a narrow bandwidth, as we have considered the case of dipole antenna. In that case, this dipole antenna is resonating on a single frequency, and this single frequency produces a narrow bandwidth, about 2%, 3% of bandwidth. But in the case of ultra wideband antenna, or in this case, the antenna produces more than 25% of the bandwidth. So this is the basic mechanism, radiation mechanism, that we have discussed in this lecture. In a summary form, we can say in this lecture we have initially discussed about the basic communication systems, then the how we can define the antenna, then types of antenna, and the radiation mechanism on a linear wire antenna or a simple conductor. Thank you everyone for watching this lecture. I hope this lecture is beneficial for you.